everybody, Emily here. This video, we are going to talk about the Senagence Senaderm Solutions exfoliators, okay? If you guys are not exfoliating your face, you need to be. Exfoliation is one of the keys to anti-aging when you're doing your skincare, and I want to talk about my two favorite products that I like to use to exfoliate my face. Okay, so we have Facial Resurfacer and the Polishing Exfoliator. I'm going to talk to you a little bit about each of these products, how to use them, how they're different, and how they are the same. Okay, so first, let's talk about what they are. Both of them are facial buffers that rid skin of impurities, remove old dead layers of skin to reveal soft, smooth skin underneath. As we age, our skin loses the ability to do this, so it's going to help correct that and get those dead layers of your skin off. Okay, so a little bit of science behind these products because I am a pharmacist and I love digging into the science. First, we'll start with the Facial Resurfacer. The Facial Resurfacer is going to be more gritty. It contains volcanic ash from Mount Vanuatu, and it has bigger particles of the volcanic ash that are actually, if you look under a microscope, they're in a sphere shape made up of 70% titanium, 30% iron, and trace amounts of calcium and magnesium. So what makes that cool is that as you buff this on your face, you are not going to make tiny cuts in your face like other exfoliators that have bits of seed can. So it's not going to harm the skin. It's going to be able to exfoliate your skin without irritation. Now, what makes the Polishing Exfoliator a little bit different than the Facial Resurfacer, it still has that volcanic ash in it to do that nice buffing. But as you can see, it is going to be a finer grit. So this is going to be used for more frequently. So you could use it almost every day to buff your face. Or if you have really sensitive skin, you could start with the Polishing Exfoliator to do a nice gentle buff. If you really like to exfoliate your skin, I would recommend getting the Facial Resurfacer, but only do this 2 to 3 times a week because it is more of a, it's a more of a bigger grit. It's going to do more of a job. It's a really nice alternative to microderm abrasion. Okay. So, other things I note about it as I use these, yes, they're exfoliating my face, but it also contains a couple things that make it feel really silky and make your skin feel really moisturized afterwards. So both of them contain Arseniplex Complex, which you'll probably learn in another video, blue seaweed, orchid flower extract, and Arnangai oil. So you're going to be getting all those ingredients in both of these. The main difference between the Polishing Exfoliator and the Facial Resurfacer, this is going to be a thicker grit, finer grit, and then this also is more of a clay-like, okay? So both are good alternatives to microderm abrasion. You should be exfoliating your face, especially as we age. Like I said, we lose that ability, and you're going to love them. Now, the other thing I always like to talk about is what they smell like. So I find with the Facial Resurfacer, it has a very clean, earthy feel. It feels very gritty, but then also silky, and that is that Nangai oil. With the Polishing Exfoliator, it has more of a clean clay mask type smell. Again, both of these are used gentle circular motions. Massage it around the skin, but avoid that eye area. Wash it off with warm water and your skin will feel baby soft and look brighter from that nice polishing. Hope you enjoyed that. Let me know if you have any questions, but if you are not exfoliating, you guys, these are the best products I have ever used. You need to check them out. See ya!